Hello everyone, welcome back to another sketchbook session, this time with gouache painting again. I have a preliminary sketch, as you can see, not a very detailed one because I'm going to just paint straight over it, and it would be kind of pointless having a very detailed sketch. Before we get any further into the painting, let me introduce myself for anyone who happens to be new here. I'm Minna, and I make a comic called Stand Still, Stay Silent. It's a Nordic post-apocalyptic adventure comic, and the character in this painting is from my comic, Sigrun, and Kitty over there in the bottom part of the drawing. They're just wandering in the woods, and they have found some sort of infected pit of bloody tendrils, I suppose. They will be visible later in the painting. But yeah, this was a little bit of a practice painting of this kind of gloomy, wintery forest scenery. I've actually been doing this kind of practice in watercolor before this in other parts of the sketchbook, because I went for a little walk, a couple hour walk in one of the local nature like trails, and it was an interesting kind of weather. It was a day when the temperatures went from like minus 15 over to like plus 1 within the span of that one day, so it was a nice combination of crisp winter air, or as crisp as you can get with the temperatures right around zero in the woods, and then around the like lake areas there was a nice mist covering everything, so it was really nice. I got some good gloomy reference pictures from that little walk that I was then using for painting practice, because as you guys know, I love my bright colors and you know, vibrant sceneries. I don't do a lot of this kind of color scenes, I don't know, this kind of colors. Even when I do a little bit more gloomier ones, there's usually very bright blue shadows or like highlight or something, just to brighten it up a little bit. But you know, you have to practice this kind of stuff too, because it is beautiful when it works out. I like when other people do very grayish drawings and paintings, and they can look really nice. And I feel like I always just, even when I intend to do a more muted palette, I always end up brightening it and brightening it until it's my usual one. And a way to not do that is to work from reference pictures, because I have to constantly be checking my path, where I'm going with the colors, and if I stray too much I have to go back to muted stuff. So yeah, that's the point of this painting, I suppose. And yeah, gouache is always a tricky medium for me. It's it has a really long period of tricky and fun. I mean, I do enjoy it, but the thing that is tricky is that it has such a long ugly stage, which is what we are in right now and are going to be in for quite some time of the video, where it just everything looks so blah. Like with watercolors, I feel like especially if you have a nice sketch or line art under it, it can kind of even start out nice from the very first like muted wash that you make on the bottom, and then it just keeps getting like better and better looking with every new layer of color that you put on it. But with gouache, you're kind of stuck in this horrific stage for a while, and it just doesn't get much better for quite some time. But spoiler alert, I guess I am happy with the result, so it won't be a horrible horrible painting at the end. But yeah, that's this painting. What else? Update for how I'm doing with the book preparation. Volume 3 of my comics printed version. Well, I guess I should have mentioned it's a webcomic. Did I mention that? No, I think I just said it's a comic. It's a webcomic, but I'm making them into printed books. And I'm working on book 3 right now, and it was actually a pretty nice, productive few days that I've had, and I've actually managed to sketch all 4 bonus comic pages for the back of the book, and I even started inking one of those pages, which is really nice, because sketching comic pages for me takes a really long time. Often they can take like 3 hours or even more, but I was able to sketch all 4 of them in, you know, one sitting basically, so almost 10 hours, but still. And well, all but except one panel, which is unfortunately the biggest one with the most characters and stuff. But yeah, I'm gonna do that one next week, I suppose. I always hate doing the panels where it's a lot of background and a lot of characters. It's like the, not the trifecta, but the diefecta of difficult things to draw that take a really long time. Especially when the characters are, you know, in the background and I have to deal with perspective and things being, you know, proportional to each other. It's always a, excuse me, a issue to deal with in the sketching stage. Once the sketch is good, then the line art thing is like whatever, it just takes a while, but it's not any harder than any other panels, but the sketching part is really tiring. And that's a panel that I'm just postponing a little bit until I have the energy to do it next week. But yeah, I have started inking the first page of them, and I think you guys will enjoy it. It's going to be a fun little mini story. It's cute and it's gonna make you guys happy when you read it eventually. Probably a little bit later than I had hoped, because I was hoping that I would be able to get all the stuff for the book done, like the print file, like early March maybe? But yeah, it's taking a little bit longer than that. Just every stage is just a tiny bit more time consuming than I had hoped, which means that all the things combined just pushes it a little bit longer. I think I'm gonna have everything done print file wise at the end of March, I think. So then it can probably go to print. But we'll see. I obviously don't like have a set date or promised anything to anyone, and no like hard deadline, so I'm not taking any stress from it. It's just I have my one day a week when I'm working on it, like once I've done everything for the comic updates for the week, and I've done my, well, that's it really. Once I've done my comic work for the week, I work on the book prep, and as long as I get one thing done every week, things are progressing and things are fine, and there is no stress from it, at least not right now, which is good, because I am annoyed by the weather and I don't need another thing to be annoyed by. Once spring and summer comes, it won't be as bad. I take stress way better obviously during summer, because everything is nice and I don't mind having a little bit of extra work and nice stuff. But winter and this time, I cannot deal with anything extra on my mind. And speaking of spring, I repotted some of my plants. Did the spring repotting that you're supposed to do when you don't have very good mulch or soil that they're growing in their pots. And I had a few that really needed new soils, because I got like my first bunch in autumn last year, and I didn't really know anything about how to keep houseplants. I just bought a few really cheap ones, and that I still have, and I didn't know that you're supposed to have like a hole at the bottom of the pot that you put them in. So I just put them in like pretty holeless ones, because that's what was for sale at the store. And I just crammed them in there, and then I found out that if you do that and you accidentally water them too much, the plants will drown, like the roots will drown, and they will rot away and everything will be horrible. So I've managed to keep them alive for the last half a year by being very careful with not overwatering and just waiting till spring to put them in new pots. And that's what I did, and I'm happy to say that none of them had rotted roots. I guess I had been good at being careful with that. Everything looked good, and I think they're gonna be hopefully happy now in better soil and drainage hole. Well, another thing that I did wrong was actually I packed like the soil way too tight when I potted them originally. Like, I thought the more soil they have around the roots, like just volume wise, just tightly packed, the better for them. Like, hey, plants like soil, the more I can fit into the pot, the better, right? It's gonna have the nutrients and stuff that they need. But no, that's actually the exact opposite. Turns out that plant roots really like air, and having really tight soil is like one of the worst things. So I was doing both wrong things, packing too tight soil and drowning them in water by accident with no drainage hole. So I have fixed that now, and hopefully my plants will be happy over the summer and the spring. And it made me happy, because it was just like an hour of doing nothing important. It was just a relaxing like playtime almost. Like, I put a garbage bag on the floor and just put all my plants and the pots and the soils and everything on there and just smooshed away at things like you do when you're a kid. And yeah, I felt like a kid playing in a sandbox. And it was really nice. It's stuff like that that really relaxes me, which is what I do during summer, obviously, working away at the in the garden, just digging stuff up, taking away weeds, and can't really do that right now. Everything is frozen. I guess some people in the south already have like almost spring. Over here everything is still covered in snow and ice. Not a lot of it though. It keeps melting away, then snowing back again, and that's not fun. But yeah, everything is still frozen. Nothing is going to be growing for a good while, I don't think. I mean, end of March, hopefully, but it's still a fair amount of time until then. Do I have any other updates for this week? I guess one unfortunate one. I dropped my laptop on my foot again. I think I mentioned this like ages ago. I did another video where I dropped my laptop on my foot, and I dropped it on my toe, and it was like blue and bruised for ages. And this time I did it again. My laptop is so heavy. It's my like a working laptop, so it has a lot of stuff in it. I think it's like 2 kilos, and it has really sharp corners for some reason, and I keep dropping it accidentally from the weight of it when I lift it and move it around. And this time I dropped it on like the middle of my foot, and I had my socks on, thankfully, and I like it hurt so much, and I quickly took the sock off because I was like feeling like it would be bleeding. And then I looked on my foot and it was like nothing was bleeding. I couldn't even see a mark, which was really weird. And I was like, man, that was lucky. It just hurt, but I don't even see like a dent anywhere like you usually get. And then I took a closer look. And do any other of you guys have this thing where if you come from a walk or you stand around a lot, you kind of get slightly bulging blue veins on your foot? My grandmother had that when she was old, like really big ones. And I was always like worried that I'm gonna get them when I get older, because I have a phobia of bulging veins. And unfortunately, yes, it is definitely happening to me too. And you know, It's just a genetic thing, I suppose. Maybe everyone gets them when they get old. But yeah, I have like blue veins just kind of bulging a little bit on my feet now that I'm over 30 years old. I'm becoming an old person. I'm sure eventually I will get them on my hands too. But anyway, I have I think like a couple of those veins on my feet, and I took a closer look at one of them, and there was like a marble sized bulge starting to happen on the blue thing, and I was like, oh no, it hit the vein directly on it, and that's why I couldn't see like a mark anywhere else, because the it was blue already, the vein, and it was just starting to get really big. And obviously it was bleeding from the vein, but the skin was still intact, so I was starting to get a really big bruise right there. And I went quickly, took a blueberry pack, a frozen blueberry pack from the freezer, and propped my foot up on some pillows and lied down, and you know, kept the frozen thing on there, like about some paper towels. And yeah, I managed thankfully to like stop it from bruising too much. It just looks like normal bruise right now, but that was a horrific experience because I have such a phobia of pains. Like when you see people like flexing their muscles and they have those bulging veins all over the place, or on their foreheads, or legs, like people who are marathon runners and you can see their veins on their legs, it is so disgusting to me. I hate it so much. Just, I have this feeling where if you poke at them, they might explode. And yeah, that's just really gross. I think I watched the, maybe it was on Grey's Anatomy or some other like hospital TV show. I remember there was a patient who had a condition, which I hope is not the real thing, where his neck vein or one of the blood vessels was too close to the surface and it was too thin-walled, and he had like this thing where if he does something too fast movements or something, it might explode and he'll just die from it. And then of course in the episode he like laughed at something and his neck exploded. Like that's my worst fear. And yeah, that's why it was so horrible. Just, it's just a normal bruise now. It hurt for a little bit because it was such a hard hit on my foot. Now it's just like feeling like a normal bruise. But does anyone else have this phobia? I'm sure people must have it. Let me know in the comments if you have a similar phobia of bulging blood vessels and what you do about it. But this was just a experience I had to share. But that's the worst thing that happened this week, which means it was a pretty good week. Got everything done that I needed to do work-wise and comic-wise. I will see you guys next week for another drawing of some sort, and I hope you had a good week. Let me know about your blood vessel phobias if you have any of those. And my comic is free to read, and see you next week. Bye bye.